Hey, what's up guys? Jeremy here from RoboDK. In today's tutorial, I will explain you how to transform a 2D sketch from SolidWorks into a real robot program. We already released a few videos on our SolidWorks plugin. Make sure to watch them to take full advantage of this new feature. The example I chose for this tutorial was brought by one of our clients in the US. They needed to pour sealants in a groove along the edges of an oil pan using a Kawasaki robot, exactly like you are seeing right now. I'm pretty sure it can be done in under 15 minutes, so let's get to work. Okay, here we have the station I created. You will understand that for some obvious intellectual property and privacy reasons, the robot, a Kawasaki RS007N, is the only thing that is part of the real station used by our client. Therefore, I redesigned everything in the station, including the dispensing tool and the oil pan. With that topic out of the way, let's do a quick tour of the station. As I already said, the robot is a Kawasaki RS007N. Here, we have the dispensing tool, and here we have the part, an oil pan, and a jig to hold it in place. All that is fixed on the precision table. The first step of this example will be to delete the part and the program. Now that we only have the jig and the robot, we are ready to start. Let's open SolidWorks. Here we have the oil pan, and on top of it, the groove we need to fill. In the previous video about our SolidWorks plugin, I showed you that you can select edges and follow them with the robot. But here, that straightforward solution is not working. Let me bring the groove a little bit closer. The goal of the project is to dispense sealants in the groove. If I use the method I showed you before, I would end up putting the sealant on either side of the groove, but not in the middle. In this case, I want to follow the center of the groove, at the top surface level. This way, the sealant can flow smoothly. This is where I'm going to use the 2D sketch. Let me show you. I'll start by creating a new sketch on top of that flat surface. Now, I will select one of the edges. Then, I will right-click on it and press select tangency. If I zoom a bit back, you'll see that the entire edge of the groove was automatically selected. I can now use the offset entities feature and enter half the width of the groove. In this case, the value will be 1.5 millimeters. As you can see, it only took me a few seconds to create a toolpath for the robot. Let me do the same for the other side of the oil pan. I'm keeping the same sketch, I'm selecting the first edge, right click, and press select tangency. Once the entire edge is selected, I can use the offset entities feature. I make sure that the value is 1.5 millimeters, okay, perfect. Now, just make sure that your sketch is visible. If it's not, you won't be able to select it with RoboDK's plugin. Next thing to do, go to the RoboDK tab and select Settings. Enter the name you want for the part in RoboDK, here Oil Pan, and the name of the reference frame you want it to be exported in. Here it's Jig. Okay, now let's select Auto Setup, and now the boring part. You need to select all the lines of your sketch one by one. Unfortunately, the select tangency option is not available here. Don't forget to also select the top surfaces. RoboDKs need them to calculate the normal and orient your tool in the right direction. Once we're done, we can click OK, and let's go back to RoboDK. The oil pan is now in place on its jig, and a curve follow project was created. A quick look at the green lines tells us that something is wrong with the order in which the path section will be executed. I can update and simulate to confirm my thoughts, and as you can see, it doesn't make any sense. Let's stop that. Okay, in the curve follow project settings, click on select curve. In the previous video, I showed you that you can reorder or switch the sense of a path section by right-clicking on it. We could also do that here, but that would take so long. Instead, I'm going to right-click an empty section of the station and reset selection. I'll then go to the starting point of my path, let's say here. I'll select the first section, and I'll make sure that it's pointing in the appropriate direction. I can then go in the top right corner of my screen and use one of the two first options, auto-select next curve or auto-select all. If I start with the first one, you will see that it's adding path section one by one. It's not super fast, but it's still better than selecting them manually. If I try the other option, auto-select all, ta-da! Every section of the path is selected in the right order. Okay, let's click done and go back to our setting window. Most of the green lines are gone and the path looks clean. Now we just need to adjust the orientation of the tool. First, press Show Preferred Tool Path to help you visualize the tool along the path. Then modify the rot Z value. Here, minus 90 degrees seems good. Let's update and simulate. Okay, that's pretty good. Okay, as usual, we can now right-click the oil pan program and generate the robot program. The .pg file is now ready to be transferred to your robot controller. So just like that, in under 15 minutes, I managed to create a complete program for my Kawasaki robot. Not bad. Okay, that's everything for today's video. Leave a thumbs up if you think this tutorial was helpful. As you may start to understand, I'm building a bunch of tutorials video covering RoboDK and its features. Just let me know in the comment section below what my next topic should be. Remember that if you have any technical questions, you can drop them on our forum. I'm pretty active on it and I'll be happy to chat about your project. That's it for now. Have a good day, guys.